Lou. For today's forced therapy practice, we're going to be streaming from inside. I've got this nice plant next to me, and I've also got a window. I can look out and see the outside, and for forced therapy, that is totally okay. You don't have to be outside. You can be inside with some things that remind you of nature. I've got this rock. And I've also got some nice sage. It smells nice. Just different things that remind you of nature. And some time that you want to take to engage in your forest therapy practice. It's really all you need. So, for today's forest therapy practice, I'll give you a little overview about what forest therapy is, and then go over the way we're going to stream today. So forest therapy is a practice of engaging with nature and contextualizing ourselves with the environment that we live in. To know that we're part of the landscapes that we walk through every day, and that we have a sense of belonging and a sense of place with them. Today we're going to start with a grounding practice, and we'll go into one or two invitations, depending on how much time I've got, and then we will close with a tea ceremony where we share what we've been through. At the end of each of those sections, we'll share what we experienced and what we're feeling, what we noticed, and we'll move through those. It should take about half an hour from start to finish. So let's start with our grounding practice. I'd like you to find a comfortable place to sit, and if it's safe to, close your eyes. And we will inhale, take a deep inhale, and a slow, calm exhale. If it's possible, make your exhale slightly longer than your inhale. So if your inhale is 1, 2, 3, our exhale is 1, 2, 3, 4, inhale, 1, 2, 3, exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now take that count on your own for a few deep breaths. We continue to inhale and exhale with our eyes closed. Let's take one hand up to our chest. And maybe take our other hand and place it on our knee or our stomach. Let's place it on our stomach. And as we inhale, we see our breath going from our mouth to our hand on our chest, to our hand on our stomach, maybe even moving that hand on our stomach slightly. And as we see that breath moving from our mouth to our chest, to our stomach, you can envision a channel coming out the top of our head and going down through our hips into the ground. And as we inhale, that channel fills with energy. And as we exhale, the energy leaves our channel. Maybe just out the sides. All sides of our channel. Now let's move that energy up and down our channel. So on the inhale, the energy moves down. On the exhale, energy moving up. And let's envision what might be outside of our body. What might be above our head or under our hips. Maybe there's a color. Maybe there's a texture. Maybe there's nothing. And let's sit with that for a few minutes. Maybe we want to change the color of our channel, the texture of our channel, the feelings that we have. So sit with that in your channel for a few minutes. Feel free to be creative around the colors, the textures, or feelings you have. I'll be back. Grounding practice. Let's think of something that we'd like to share. Maybe something you noticed, and I can start. I think one thing that I noticed was how easy it was to change directions of the energy as I was breathing, and how fun and creative it felt to kind of decide the colors that I was interacting with or the feelings that I was interacting with in the practice. If you'd like to share what you noticed during our grounding practice or what you're noticing now, you can just say it out loud, or if you want to chat it, that's awesome too. First invitation, I'd invite you to maybe make a small piece of art. Maybe if you're outside, you can find some leaves, put them in a pattern that looks beautiful to you, or maybe some sticks. Maybe you want to etch something in the dirt, or look at a cloud that's going by and imagine how you might paint it. If you're in your home or, oops, you're just viewing nature out a window today, like I am, then maybe take some of those things that you found that have a meaning to you for nature and assemble them, or maybe think about a way that you, what art might look like for you interacting with those pieces. So I'm going to give you about 7 minutes to play around and make some art, and I will do the same, and I'll see you back in a little bit. So this, I made a little art project over here on my plants. With some flowers, some origami flowers I found. I just clipped them on there. Cute. I hope you made a little art project yourself. And if you want to share what you're noticing after that small invitation, go ahead and either share out loud or put it in the chat. I think what I'm noticing is that I made these little origami flowers before, and I just never clipped them onto the plant, but they look pretty cute like that, so I might just leave them. I think for me, when I started this invitation, it was felt a little challenging to try and engage with art, you know, in such a short time, or I worried that I'd make something kind of unimportant or couldn't share it. But just that's kind of what came up for me today, what I'm noticing. Alright, and for our next invitation, I'd like you to pick one part of the nature around you. And just focus on that for 7 minutes. Maybe interacting with it or just viewing it for 7 minutes, smelling or touching it for 7 minutes, and just focusing on one piece of nature that you want to interact with. And just find all the different ways that you can interact with that. And I'll see you in about 7 minutes. Okay, so if you want to come back and share what we're noticing from that last invitation, I was focusing on a plant that's outside my window, and I was noticing, just the longer I looked at it, the more things came up. I started just looking at the leaves, and then I noticed the light coming through the leaves, and then I noticed all the different layers of leaves and how those affected the light. And yeah, just the longer I viewed it, the more there was to see. That's what I noticed. And also, it was kind of difficult to focus on one thing for a long time. Even 7 minutes seemed like a long time to focus on one thing, and I found myself kind of looking at other things also. If you want to share what you noticed, or maybe share just out loud to yourself or in the chat what you're noticing right now. And since I'm inside today, I will practice the tea ceremony part of our forest therapy practice, which is our closing practice. So I made myself some tea here. It's raspberry leaf tea. It's from a tea maker in Eastern Europe. The packaging is not in English, so I think it definitely has raspberry leaf and probably some other things. And I invite you to go and have a nice warm drink. Maybe bring it back. And if we could just share what we think would be helpful to close out this practice today. If there's anything you feel that sharing would make it feel a more complete practice, or just something you want to say before we go back into our daily lives. I'll let you go first. Feel free to say it in the chat or just out loud to yourself. Okay, I'm gonna go now. I think for me, this practice helps my daily life. It helps everything feel a bit more calm and helps everything feel almost like I'm doing more, like I feel more accomplished after my day ends. Just a bigger sense of calm and just a greater sense that everything's okay and I'm doing the best, and that's great. So thanks today for sharing this forest therapy practice with me. I hope that you have a nice few minutes after this to enjoy your beverage of choice, whether that's tea or coffee or just some hot water, something just to warm you up a little bit. And I will talk to you later. Hope you have a very nice rest of your day. Bye.